Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do this puzzle problem. In a triangle, the lengths of the sides are consecutive integers. The perimeter is 11 more than twice the shortest side. What is the perimeter? First of all, you have to know what consecutive integers are. So consecutive integers are numbers like 5, 6, 7, one after the other, or you might have 20, 21, 22. That would be three consecutive integers, etc. So if you have one number, the next consecutive integer is one more than that. So if the first one's n, whatever that number is, you would have to add one to it to get the next number. And you would have to add one to that to get the next number. And you'd have to add one to that to get the next number, etc. So in other words, so this goes on and on. If the first number would be 10, the next number would be 10 plus 1, which would be 11. This would be 10 plus 2, which would be 12. This would be 10 plus 3, would be 13, etc. Right, so we have to know that. That's what consecutive integers means. So we're going to define our sides using that idea. The first, second, and third side. So if the first one's n, all right, so we don't know what it is, what would the next one be? It would be n plus 1. And the third side would be n plus 2. So this is the shortest side, right? The smallest number is the shortest side in this case. And we're going to assume these are positive numbers as well. Next part. The perimeter is 11 more than twice the shortest side. Okay, perimeter means you add the three sides. So in other words, I want to add my first side. This is not the really mathematical part, but it's a way of thinking of it. The first side plus the second side plus the third side, that's the perimeter. And it says that that's going to be the same thing as, this is, kind of, I don't like to use equal signs this way, but it says that's basically going to be the same thing as 11 more than twice the shortest side. So I'm going to take twice the shortest side, which in this case would be the first side, and I'm going to add 11 to it. Okay, so this is a way of thinking about it. So let's actually write down what those pieces are. The first side is n, the second side is n plus 1, and the third side is n plus 2. Some people like to put each of these in parentheses, that's okay. But then you would take them off at the next step. And that's going to be the same thing as 2 times the first side. Well, what's the first side? It's n. So it's 2 times n, right, plus 11. So that's 11 more than twice the shortest side. So now we have an equation. So to solve this equation, let's simplify the left-hand side by combining like terms. Remember, n plus n plus n, you've got 3n. Remember, you add the coefficients, 1 plus 1 plus 1. 3n plus 3 is equal to 2n plus 11. So we can subtract 2n from both sides. So we get the variables on the left-hand side, and I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides so that the constants are in the right. So what I'm doing is I'm adding a negative 2n minus 3 to both sides. You could think of it that way. So what do I have on the left? Oh, how convenient. I just get n equals 8. So I found n. Now, what did n stand for? It stood for the shortest side. And notice this problem had nothing about feet or inches, so it was sort of a puzzle problem. We weren't given any units, so it was just asking in numbers. So in this case, we don't have to write feet or inches because the problem didn't give us any units. So those would be our numbers, 8, 9, and 10. Those are three consecutive integers, right? So if n is 8, the next number would be 9, next number would be 10. And now, what's the question? So I've got three consecutive integers. I did that part right. But the other thing it said was what? All right, so if we read this again, it said that the perimeter is 11 more than twice the shortest side. Let's make sure that's true. Well, what would the perimeter of the triangle be if we had 8, 9, and 10? We'd have 8, 9, and 10. That adds up to 27. All right, so we're wondering if that's really true. Is that the perimeter? So the question is this. Is 27, right, the perimeter, is that 11 more than twice the shortest side? Well, the shortest side is 8. So what's twice the shortest side? 16. And if I add 11, I get 27. So that makes sense. All right, so what we've got here is that the sides are 8, 9, and 10, and the perimeter is 27. And all of this makes sense given our original problem here. And so the question is, what is the perimeter? So that's all we have to do is write 27. Or we could actually write it out in words, which is how I usually do it. I would write the perimeter is 27. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.